بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده ونصلي ونسلم على رسوله الكريم أما بعد. Continuing on the chapter of the importance of appearance, the next section or topic he brings up is Imam Shaykh Abd al-Fattah Abu Ghudda is arriving from a journey. And a lot of times when we're traveling, when we're going to someone's house or someone is hosting us, he speaks about this particular hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam directed his companions upon returning from a journey, that you are on your way to meet your brothers, put on a nice dress and fix your saddles. Meaning in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they used to ride on animals. So fix your saddles so you appear distinct among people as a beauty mark on a beautiful face. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not like roughness or rough manners. So when you're coming to someone's house or someone is hosting you, both the host and the person who is coming are advised by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to come in a manner that you're presentable to the host. And the guests, when they arrive there, it's pleasant seeing this person hosting us, that you actually feel comfortable that yes, he is ready to host us. And a person is more comfortable like that, that when you're seeing that yes, you're giving their presence a source of specialty by making sure that you're dressed accordingly and you're dressed, you're well-mannered and well-dressed. And likewise, a person coming to someone's house, let it be after a long journey or let it be a regular invitation, being dressed properly and making sure you're coming in a respected manner, in a manner that is appropriate and befitting to the person. But not only that, he is also mentioning the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, tahadu tahabu, which is narrated by Imam Bukhari rahimahullah, that exchange gifts, it will create love for one another. So when you go to someone's house or you go to someone's place upon an invitation, take something to their house. Take something for them, something that they will remember you by. And that thing that you give them should be something of benefit to them. You know, sometimes you might take something which isn't the most useful thing for them. A person who never writes notes in his life, you go and give him a pen, it's not a beneficial gift for him, right? So a person who is studying, maybe something, give him books, literature, something that will help him. Someone who is studying deen, give him Islamic books. And things of this nature, something that will be beneficial for the person you are giving gift to. So that way, every time that person looks at that gift, he remembers you and a dua comes out of his heart for you. Right? And again, this is exchanging love. This is exchanging, the Prophet ﷺ is saying, by exchanging gifts, you are building that love in the heart of this individual, and by him reciprocating that same love by giving and exchanging back with you, by giving gifts in return. And then the second part, which we have gone over almost in every single section, was dressing properly and dressing neatly. SubhanAllah, when we meet one another, even if it's our buddy's house, the Prophet ﷺ has advised the Sahaba to look appropriate. When you're going to someone's house, when you're going to chill with someone, you know, look in a manner which is decent and appropriate for the gathering. And that is very important. And if that's how much importance the Prophet ﷺ has given to gatherings with our friends and family, then imagine when we are coming to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how much more importance the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would have given to praying salawat in the masjid and house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There was one tabi'i, the student of Anas ibn Malik, Thabit al-Banani, rahmatullahi alayhi, who said that Anas bin Malik, about Anas bin Malik, he said, when I used to visit Anas bin Malik radiallahu anhu, great sahabi, prominent sahabi, when I used to visit him, he would call for a perfume and run it along his cheeks just so he is smelling good in front of his guest. Imagine the status of a sahabi, and this is how he is treating a tabi'i. Someone without a doubt who is in ranks of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, definitely sahabi is first and then the tabi'i. But that's how much respect they had for their manner, for their guests, for the people who are coming over. And this is the kind of appropriateness that we should adopt when we have someone coming to our house, making sure that we are dressed appropriately, and if we are visiting someone, making sure we are also well dressed in that regard as well. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all tawfiq and grant us the etiquettes and manners of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Jazakumullahu khair. Akhiru da'wana. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.